Hello, my name is Keshwani. That's K-E-S-H-W-A-N-I, Keshwani. Today, in this video, we'll learn all about prime factors. Prime factors. Prime factors. How do we find prime factors, and what do we mean by the term prime factors? Let's start with something simple. The first five problems that we'll do are going to be very simple, very straightforward. We're going to do altogether 18 problems in this video. The whole point of the entire video, you have to be patient, or if you're not patient, you can forward the video. And if we can solve the last three problems, problem number 16, 17, and 18 in this video, then you have mastered the concept of prime factors and you understand how this concept will be tested in the exam. In the exam, whether you're preparing for, as I always remind you, it doesn't matter whether you're preparing for GRE or GMAT or SAT or ACT or TEAS or HESI, in any of these exams, they're not going to simply ask you what are the prime factors of this and this number. The question is going to be a little bit more convoluted, and you have to be able to understand by reading the problem that's essentially what they're looking for. They're looking for prime factors of this number. But the question is going to be worded in a very strange, very peculiar, as I said, very convoluted way. So at the end of the video, if you can solve problem number 16, 17, and 18, then you have arrived. But we're going to start out with something very simple, very straightforward. Simple problems, first five problems are going to be very straightforward, as I said. Let's begin. Problem number one. What are prime factors of 6? If you want to find prime factors of 6, it's very simple. You write down your 6 and you ask yourself, what's the smallest prime number that you can find that 6 is evenly divisible by? I'm not going to explain it this much detail in every single problem, but here we go. The smallest prime factor is 2. 2 is this. Prime factor simply means it has to be a factor of 6 and it must be a prime number. Do you understand? It's 2. And when we do that, it's 3, and 3 itself is a prime number, so we're done. When we arrive at the prime number at the end, we're done. So the prime factors of 6 are 2 and 3. Prime factors are 2 and 3 of 6. What if the question asks you all factors? If the problem asks you list all factors of 6? Well, it's very simple. If you have to list all factors of 6, you have your prime factors. And then always make sure, always, always, always make sure, if you are asked to make a list of all the factors of a given number, to start your list with 1. Because 1 is a factor of any number. Any number can be divided evenly by 1. So 1 has to be the starting point. Always begin your list with 1 and always end your list with the number itself. Whatever the number that was given to you, that number is a factor of itself. 6, of course, is evenly divisible by 6. So that's it. Those are all the factors of 6. And if they ask you for the prime factors are simply 2 and 3. 2 and 3 are the only two prime numbers that we can divide 6 evenly by. Number 2, 10. Same thing, 10, you divide by 2 is the smallest prime factors, and if we arrive at 5, 5 is the prime number, we are done. The factors are 2 and 5. 2 and 5. If they ask you for all the factors of 10, that's very straightforward. Here we have to insert 1 and finally the 10. Let's go on. How about 14? 14. Let's do 14 here. Again, we divide by 2 and we arrive at 7, we are done. 2 and 7. And again, 2 and 7. And then if we have to list all the factors, we're going to start our list with 1, and we're going to end with the number itself. As you can see, it's very silly, but soon it's going to end. First five questions, as I said, are going to be silly, simple. How about 18? How about 18? If you look at 18, the smallest prime number that we can find, prime factor of 18 is 2, we get a 9, and then 9 can be divided by 3 and we get a 3. Since we ended up with the prime number at the end, that's where the story ends. As soon as we hit the prime number at the end, the story ends, which means what we're saying here is that 18 is made up of 18 equals 2 times 3 squared. What are the prime factors of 18?
The prime factors of 18 are 2 and 3.
2 and 3 are the only 2 and 3 are the only two prime numbers that we can use to divide 18 evenly, that is. If you have to list all the numbers, all the factors, then this gets a little tricky. Again, we start our list with 1, then we have a 2, then of course we have a 3, but 18 can be divided by 6, it can be divided by, what else can we divide 18 by? Oh, 9, I almost forgot 9, it can be divided by 9 and finally 18. As you can see, as the number gets larger, we're not going to keep listing all the factors because the list is going to get very annoying and very long. For example, the next one here, I'm not going to list all the factors. Actually, maybe I will. Maybe one more time we're going to list all the factors. But eventually we're going to stop listing all the factors. We're just interested in learning how to find the prime factors. So here's the next one, 100. If you have to find prime factors of 100, we do the same thing what we always did, which is take 100, divided by the smallest prime number that we can find, which is 2, we get 50, divide by 2 again, we get 25, 25 we divide by 5, and we get a 5, of course. Of course, we know that 100 is made up of 4 times 25, everybody knows that, which is exactly what we see here. 100 is equal to 2 squared times 5 squared, which means the prime factors of 100 are 2 and 5. If the question asks you to list all the factors, then it gets a little tricky. All factors of 100 are going to be, I should have squeezed 18 up here somewhere, there we go, so that I can make the list here. 1, 2, we're making a list of all factors of 2. I'm not going to look at my work here, I'm going to keep my fingers crossed that I don't miss anything. 1, 2 can be, 100 can be divided by 2, 4, 5, 10, 20, 25, 50, and finally 100. So I hope I did not miss anything. I'm going to check. 1, 2, 4, 5, 10. 1, 2, 4, 5, 10. 20, 25, 50. As you can see, the list gets to be quite long and quite annoying. So we're going to stop doing that. We're just going to list prime factors, starting with problem number 6. And if you want to do that yourself, you can do that yourself also. As soon as I put the problem on the blackboard, you can pause the video and do it yourself. Here's number 6. 156. How do you find prime factors of 156? Same as before. I should have started number 6 from the top here. Since 156 is an even number, we can divide it by 2. So let's divide by 2. And watch what happens. How many 2's does 1 have? 1 has no 2's. That one goes and joins the 5 and becomes 15. That one goes and joins the 5 and becomes 15. How many 2's does 15 have? 15 has 7 2's. 7 2's are 14. 7 2's are 14. 7 2's are 14. That's what we're saying. That's the language. 7 2's are 14. Once we take away 14 from the 15, we have a remainder of 1. That 1 goes and joins the 6 and becomes 16. And 16 has 8 2's. 8 2's. 15 was gone. That's it. That's also an even number. 78 is also an even number, which means we can divide by 2 one more time. How many 2's does 7 have? 7 has 3 2's. 3 2's are 6. 3 2's are 6. The remaining one, the remainder of 1 goes and joins the 8 and becomes 18. And 18 has 9 2's. That's it. We can no longer divide by 2, but we can divide by 3. Let's divide it by 3 and we get 1 and 3. In other words, what we just established is that 156 is equal to 2 squared, you see, 1 and 2, and then a 3 times 3 times 13. And therefore, the prime factors of 156 are 2, 3, and 13. We're not going to list all the factors because that would be silly. So that was number 6. Let's do number 7. Problem number 7. How about 108? Let's do it on the top. There's no reason why we should keep squeezing it. 108 is the next one I want to do. Starting with problem number 8, we're going to erase everything, okay? Do it yourself, 108. Divide by 2. how many twos does one have? One has no twos. One has no twos. That one goes and joins the 0 and becomes 10. How many twos does 10 have? 10 has 5 twos. How many twos does 8 have? 8 has 4 twos. So 10 was gone and 8 is gone. We get a 54, it's also an even number, we can divide by 2 one more time. How many twos does 5 have? 5 has 2 twos. 2 twos are 4. 2 twos are 4. The remaining one goes and joins the 4, becomes 14, and 14 has 7 twos. 14 has 7 twos. We can no longer divide by 2, let's divide by 3. How many twos does 2 have? 2 has no. How many 3's does 2 have? 2 has no 3's. Then 2 goes and joins the 7 and becomes 27, and 27 has 9 3's. 9 3's at 27. We can divide by 3 one more time, and we get a 3 at the end. Since we got a 3 at the end, the story ends. In other words, 108, in other words, we just found out that 108 is equal to 2 squared, you see 1 and 2, times 3 cubed, 1, 2, and 3, 3 cubed. What are the prime factors of 108? If somebody asks you, you tell them the prime factors of 108 are simply 2 and 3. Those are the only two factors that 108 has out of all the factors. If you were to sit there and make a list of all the factors of 108, the list is going to be quite long. But out of all of those factors of 108 that you will make a list of, only two of those factors will qualify as prime numbers, prime factors. And those two prime factors we just found out are 2 and 3, and nothing else. Let's do problem number 8. As I said, we're going to do 18 of them. Let's begin. 372 happens to be an even number, which means we can divide it by 2. So let's do that, shall we? You and I together. How many 2's does 3 have? 3 has 1 2's. We're dividing it by 2. How many 3's, how many 2's does 3 have? 3 has 1 2. After we take away 2 from the 3, we have a remainder of 1. That 1 goes and joins a 7 and becomes 17. How many 2's does 17 have? 17 has 8 2's. 8 2's are 16. 8 2's are 16. After we take away 16 from the 17, the remaining one goes and joins the 2 and becomes 12. And 12 is made up of 6 2's. That's also an even number. We can go one more round. How many 2's does 18 have? 18 has 9 2's. 18 has 9 2's. How many 2's does 3 have? 3 has 3. 6 has 3 2's. We can no longer divide by 2. We can divide by 3. We end up with 3 and 1. And 31 is a prime number. 31 is a prime number. You must know your prime numbers. And if you don't know your prime numbers, watch the videos in my basic math series right here, basic math. Just type in my name, just type in Keshwani. Anytime you're looking for a topic, any particular topic, just type in my name and the name of the topic, just type in prime numbers and then Keshwani, or Keshwani and then prime numbers. And the videos will pop right up, and you watch those two videos. There are two videos. In one video, we learn our prime numbers 1 through 50. In the next videos, we learn our prime numbers from 51 through 100. Make sure you know your prime numbers. Make sure you know all your prime numbers. Make sure that you're able to recognize the prime numbers when you see one without having to put in too much time into it, because it comes in very handy during the exam. And when I say during the exam, I'm talking about the exam that you will take. It does not matter whether you're preparing for GRE or GMAT or TEAS or HESI or SAT or SCT. These are very basic math concepts that you must have, that one must have at one's fingertips. You understand? Amen. That was the end of the lecture. That was the end of the sermon, rather. Amen. So what did we just establish here? What we just established here is that 372 is equal to 2 squared, you see, 1 and 2. 2 squared times 3 times 31, right here, times 31. So that's your 372. And therefore, what are the prime factors of 372? The prime factors of 332, are 2, 2, 3, and 31.
31 is a prime number. We recognize it because we know our prime numbers. This is number 9.
Oh, number 9 is nasty.
It is very, very nasty. I don't know what to do with it.
Why don't you pause the video and do it yourself? Find out all the prime factors of 1 million. Go ahead and do it right now. Well, what we have to understand here is that 1 million is simply 10 raised to 6. You can clearly see here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 zeros, 10 raised to 6. 10 raised to 6, 10, 10 is essentially made up of 5 times 2, 5 times 2 raised to 6, which in turn can be written as 5 to the 6 and 2 to the 6, that's your 1 million. And therefore, the prime factors of 1 million are simply 2 and 5. There are no other prime numbers. 1 million cannot be evenly divided. 1 million cannot be evenly divided by any other prime numbers except 2 and 5. There are no other prime numbers that you can use to divide 1 million by evenly. That is number 10. Number 10. 144.
What can we do? Divide by 2, divide by 2, 14 has 7 2's, 4 has 2 2's, it's an even number, let's divide by 2 one more time. 7 is made up of 3 2's, the remaining one goes and joins the 2, becomes 12, and 12 has 6 2's. That's an even number, let's go one more time by 2, 3 has 1 2's, the remaining one goes and joins the 6 and becomes 16, and 16 has 8 2's. That's an even number, let's divide one more time, 18 has 9 2's. We can no longer divide by 2, so we divide by 3. Voila. That's it. In other words, what we just found out is that 144 is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. 2 raised to 4 times 3 squared. In other words, prime factors of 144 are 2 and 3. Those are the only two prime numbers. 2 and 3 are the only two prime numbers that we can use to divide 144 evenly. No other prime numbers will work. If you divide 144 by any other prime numbers, it will not be evenly divisible. 2 and 3 are the only prime factors that 144 possesses. Number 11. What can we do? 585.
I should have done it a little bit higher.
Because I just realized I need to write something.
Well, what can we do here? We cannot divide 585 by 2, but we can divide it by 5 because it ends in a 5. If something ends in a 5 or a 0, it's divisible by 5. But before you divide by 5, it's very important that you go in proper sequence. The rule is that you must divide the number, given quantity, by smallest prime number that you can find. The smallest prime number that we can find here is not 5. This number is in fact divisible by 3. How do we know that 585 is divisible by 3? Because we know our divisibility rules. How did I phrase it? Rules of divisibility, or divisibility rule, whatever you want to call it.
Again, basic math, day 25.
Just type in, you don't want to type all of this part, you just type in basic math. Day 25 and watch that video and learn the rules of divisibility. And if you feel that your math skill is a little bit poorer than it ought to be, if you feel that it's not at par, if it's subpar, then you might want to watch some more videos out of the basic math series, because that's what it's about. It's about very basic, very elementary math concepts.
Day number 25.
And in our divisibility rules on day number 25 in basic math series, we learn that if the sum of the digit, if the sum, S-U-M, sum of the digits is divisible by 3, then the number itself is divisible by 3. What we find here is that we have 5 plus 5 is 10, 10 plus 8 is 18, 18 is divisible by 3. Since 18, since the sum of the digits is divisible by 3, the number itself is divisible by 3 because 18 can be divided by 3. So we're not going to divide by 5 to start out with. The proper procedure is to start with 3. Let's start with 3. In this case, it's not going to make any difference, but it has the potential of causing problems in some cases. Not always, but some cases. So don't get in the bad habit. Get in the right habit right away from the very beginning. Always start with the smallest possible prime factors that you can find. The smallest possible prime factors. If the number is divisible by 3 and 5, don't divide by 5 first. Divide by 3. How many 3's does 5 have? 5 has 1 3. 5 has only 1 3. Once we take away 3 from the 5, let's erase this thing on the top. It might confuse you as to what the hell it is. Once we take away 3 from the 5, we have a remainder of 2. What happens to that 2? That 2 goes and joins the 8 and becomes 28. How many 3's does 28 have? 28 has 9 3's. 9 3's are 27. 9 3's are 27. After we take away 27 from the 28, we have a remainder of 1. That 1 goes and joins the 5 and becomes 15. And 15 has 5 3's. As you can clearly see, 585 was indeed evenly divisible by 3. We just got whole number 195. Do you understand? What was I going to say here? It's also very important that you know your times table. You must know your times table by heart, 1 through 10 minimum, at the very least. 1 through 12 is even better. And of course, 1 through 20 is just dandy. Even myself, I do not know 1 through 20. But you should know your times table 1 through 12. That's the absolute minimum. Do you understand? That's the absolute minimum. That's how you do this division in your head. Because we know our times table. We know our table of 3. So one more time, how many 3's does 5 have? 5 has 1 3, once we take away 3 from it, the remaining 2 goes and joins the 8, becomes 28. 28, how many 3's does 28 have? 28 has 9 3's, 9 3's are 27. After we take away 27 from 28, the remaining 1 goes and joins the 5, becomes 15, and 15 has 5 3's. Voila. Again, we see that we have a 9 plus 1 is 10, and here we have a 5, that's 15. 15 is divisible by 3. Since 15 is divisible by 3, that tells us that 195 is divisible by 3. 195 is divisible by 3 because the sum of the digits is 15, and therefore 195 is divisible by 3. 195 is divisible by 3, so is 294, and so is 393 is a silly example. You can clearly see by each digit individually. So and so is 492. 492 is divisible by 3 because 4 plus 2 is 6, 6 is divisible by 3, and 9 is divisible by 3. All of these numbers are divisible by 3 because the sum of the digits is 15 in all of these cases. The point here is not that sum is 15, the point here is that the sum of the digits of these numbers is divisible by 3. We're going to divide by 3. How many 3's does 1 have? 1 has no 3. 1, poor 1 has no 3. It's just a 1. That 1 goes and joins the 9 and becomes 19. How many 3's does 19 have? 19 has 6 3's. 6 3's are 18. 6 3's are 18. The remaining one goes, it drops to 5 and becomes 15. And 15 has 5 3's. 6 plus 5 is 11. 6 plus 5 is 11. We can no longer divide by 3. We're going to have to divide by 5. How many 5 does 6 have? 6 has 1 5. 6 has 1 5. The remaining one goes, it drops to 5 and becomes 15. And 15 has 3 5's. And 13 is a prime number. That means the story ends. 13 is a prime number. We hit a prime numbers. So in this, when you're looking at prime factors, there are basic things you have to have at your fingertips. You must be able to recognize your prime fact. You must be able to recognize your prime numbers, and you must know your timetables. Those are must. In other words, what we just found out is 585 is equal to 3 squared times 5 times 13. And prime factors are 3, 5, and 13. Let's do number 12. number 12. As I said, we're going to do 18 of them. And the whole point you're watching this video so patiently is to find out if we can do the last three problems. Because that's how this concept is going to appear in the exam, the way I'm going to present to you in the last three problems.
But that's not the only way, but that's one of the ways.
72. Next one is 72. Let's see what we can do with 72. 72 should go quite fairly quickly. Divide by 2. 7 has 3 2's. The remaining one goes, it joins the 2, becomes 12. 12 has 6 2's. Divide by 2, 3 has 1 2, the remaining one goes, joins the 6 and becomes 16, and 16 has 8 2's. Divide by 2 one more time, we get a 9, divide by 3, we get a 3, that's it. So 72 is made up of 1, 2, 3, 2 cubed times 3 squared. And therefore, the prime factors of 72 are 2 and 3. Those are the only two prime numbers that you can divide 72 by. Let's do number 13. Number 13 says 56. Divide by 2. How many 2's does 5 have? 5 has 2 2's. 2 2's are 4. The remaining one goes and joins the 6 and becomes 16. 16 has 8 2's. Divide by 2 one more time. 2 has 1 2. 8 has 4 2's. Divide by 2 one more time. You get a 7. That's it. That's where the story ends. In other words, 56 is made up of 2 cubed times 7. Of course, it's made up of 2 cubed times 7 because 56 is 8 7. 8 7s are 56. How do I know that 8 7s are 56? Because 7 7s, I know my 7 7. 7 7 is the perfect 7. 7 squared, 7 is, seven squared is 49. 49 is a perfect square. That I do know. 49 is a perfect square, which is made up of 7 7s. If 7 7s are 49, then if you were to add one more 7 to it, we'll get 8 7s, then 49 plus another 7, 49 plus 1 is 50, and then 6, the remaining 6 here, 56. 56 is made up of 8 7s. Prime factors of 56 are 2 and 7, that's all. Those are the only two prime numbers that we can divide 56 by. Number 14. Number 14 is something that I want you to try by yourself. First, 7,150. 7,150. I insist that you pause the video and do it yourself. 7,150, do it yourself, pause the video. All right. I'm going to erase all of this thing. We don't need any of this now, so we have the room. What we have to understand is that if you were to leave 7,150 as 7,150, it will turn into a freak show, because it's a very large number. It will take forever and ever to end the story. So don't do that. Don't leave the 7,150 as 7,150. Break it up into 715 times 10. And 10 is very simple. 10 is made up of 2 and 5. So that part is very simple. 10 has only two prime factors, 2 and 5. Let's work on this guy. Can we divide this number by 3? We cannot divide by 2, obviously. Let's find out. 7 plus 1 is 8. 8 plus 5 is 13. 13 is not divisible by 3. Since sum of the digits is 13 and 13 is not divisible by 3, 715 is not divisible by 3. So we're going to have to divide by 5. How many 5 does 7 have? 7 has 1 5. The remaining 2 goes and joins the 1, becomes 21. 21 has 4 5s. After we take away 20 from 21, we have a remainder of 1. That 1 goes and joins the 5 and becomes 15. 15 has 3 5s. Can we divide this number by 2? Obviously not. It's an odd number. Can we divide by 3? 4 plus 1 is 5. 5 plus 3 is 8. It's not going to be divisible by 3. How about 5? It's not divisible by 5 because it doesn't end in a 5 or a 0. There is no point in checking for 6 because in order for a number to be divisible by 6, first of all, it has to be an even number. It is not, so it's not divisible by 6. A number must be an even number. That's the first thing we check, and then the sum of the digits of the number has to be divisible by 3. If you can establish that it's an even number, which tells you that the given number is divisible by 2, and then you look at the sum of its digits, And if the sum of the digits is divisible by 3, then you establish that it's divisible by 3. If the number is divisible by 2 and it is divisible by 3, then it's divisible by 6. But we don't have to worry about a 3 part. We don't have to worry about whether or not this number is divisible by 3, because it's not even an even number. So it's not divisible by 6. Let's try 7. Shall we? Are we going to be divided by 7? Are we going to be able to divide this number by 7? Of course not. Because if you were to divide by 7, 14 has 2 sevens. How many sevens does 3 have? How many sevens does 3 have? 3 has no sevens. 3 has no sevens. That 3 is the remainder. That 3 is the remainder to be divided by 7. We're going to end up as 20 and 3 sevenths. If you don't believe me, do it out. 143, if you divide by 7, you're going to get 2 on the top. You're going to get 2 on the top. That's 14. 3 comes down. Three has no sevens, and that's your remainder. So therefore, the answer is 20 3/7. We don't have to do any of this. We don't have to turn it into a freak show to see that it's not divisible by 7. Because 14 is divisible by 7, we have a remainder. We have a 3. 3 is not going to be divisible by 7. It's not divisible by 7. We don't have to worry about wanting to see whether or not it's divisible by 8 because it's not divisible by 2. We don't have to worry about whether or not it's divisible by 9 because it's not divisible by 3. It's not divisible by 10 because it doesn't end in a 0. Let's try 11, shall we? Let's try 11. See if this number is divisible by 11, shall we? Let's see what happens. Shall we? Let's divide by 11. How many 11 does 1 have? 1 has no 11s. 1 has no 11s. That 1 goes and joins the 4 and becomes 14. How many 11s does 14 have? 14 has 1 11. 14 has 1 11. After we take away 11 from the 14, we have a remainder of 3. That 3 goes and joins this 3 and becomes 33. Aha! 33. 33 is evenly divisible by 11. 33 has 3. 33 has 3 11s. Voila, that's it, we are done. That's 13 is an even. 13 is a prime number. The story finishes. The story ends. In other words, 715 equals 5 times 11 times 13. 5 times 11 times 13. And 10 is made up of 2 and 5. 715 is made up of 5 times 11 times 13. So now we list our prime numbers. In other words, 7150, we just found out, equals 2. Let's do it in a different color so we can see it. 2. And then we have a 5. And we have a 5 here. So we have 5 squared. Then we have 11. And then we have a 13. And those are your prime factors. Prime factors are 2, 5, 11, and 13. Prime factors of 7150 are 2, 5, 11, and 13. Let's do the next one. Shall we? Number 15. I'm debating here whether or not this number was 7150. Well, we'll worry about the problem in a second. Let's just do this thing here. I don't want to digress. The next one is 63,000. Again, pause the video. Do it yourself. 63,000. 63,000. I'll give you a second. I'll give you 5 seconds for you to be able to pause and unpause the video. I am out of my tea here, so I can. Anyway, again, don't leave the 63,000 as 63,000 because it's going to turn into a hell. A freak show, do you understand? It's going to turn into a freaking hell. Break it up into, realize that 63,000 is simply 63 times 1,000. And 1,000, of course, is very simple. The prime factors of 1,000 are 2 and 5. Because 1,000 is simply 10 raised to 3, which is simply 5 times 2 raised to 3, which is simply 5 to the 3 and 2 to the 3, which means prime factors of 1,000 are 5 and 2. We, of course, knew it. Let's work on 63. Divide by 3. We get a 2 and a 1, divide by 3, we get a 7. That's it, we are done.
In other words, 63,000 equals, in other words, 63,000 equals,
let's put it in a different color again.
63,000 equals 2 cubed times 3 squared times 5 cubed times 7.
Voila. And therefore, the prime factors of 63,000,
prime factors of 63,000 are 2, 3, they're right here. 2, R, let's put them right underneath it, are 2, 3, 5, and 7. That's it.
2, 3, 5, and 7 are the prime factors of 63,000. Now we're going to do problem number 16, 17, and 18.
16, 17, and 18, the last three problems are word problems. So you're going to have to be patient with me because I have to put down the problem on the blackboard first. It's going to take a while because it's a very long problem.
Here we go.
We are told that a container is filled with red, white, blue, and green marbles.
It's filled up, the container is filled with red,
white, blue, and green marbles or balls or whatever you want to call it. You understand?
Each worth, which is why I'm writing in such an awkward way, because we can line them up. Each worth, 2, 3, 5, and 7 points. Of course, in the exam, it's not going to be written out like this. I wanted to line up the colors with the points respectively. A number of marbles. Second sentence. That's the first sentence. Here's the second sentence. A number of marbles. Again. Removed from the container and their point values recorded. Here's the third sentence. If the product of all the point values of the removed marbles equals problem number 16, 210, problem number 17, 63,000. Problem number 18, 147,000.
We're going to do each one of these problems one by one. So here's the first. I'm going to read the problem one more time to you, slowly, in the event that you have trouble with my handwriting.
A container, we are told, is filled with red, white, blue, and green marbles. Each worth 2, 3, 5, and 7 points respectively. A number of marbles are then removed from the container and their point values are recorded. So we remove a marble, we see what color it is, and we make a note of it that it was 3 points. We put color the next one, we realize it's blue, and we make a note that it's 5 points, and we make a list of all the points and their points value recorded. If the product of if the product of all the points values removed from the marbles equals question number 16, 210, question number 17, if the product of all the points values of the removed marbles equals 63,000, if the product of all the points value equals 147,000, so I haven't written the punchline yet, how many, this H should not be capitalized because it's the continuation of this sentence, it's not a new sentence, how many of each type of marbles were removed? That's it. How many of each type of marbles were removed? I'm going to get out of your way now for a few seconds so that you have unobstructed view of the problem, because then I'm going to have to erase it. You understand? We need the room. So one more time, we have a container filled with red, white, blue, and green marbles. Each is worth 2, 3, 5, and 7 points respectively. A number of marbles were removed and their points were recorded. We are told that the product of all the point values of the removed marbles equals, in question number 16, 210, in which case question is how many of each type of marbles were removed. In question number 17, the product of point values equals 63,000. In the next problem, it equals 147,000. Are you able to see right away that they're simply asking you for prime factors? This is how they ask you the question in the exam. They're not going to simply ask you what are the prime factors of 210, but that's essentially what they're asking here. Notice the values that they're giving you of each color. Notice the values 2, 3, 5, and 7. 2, 3, 5, and 7, not 2, 3, 6, and 7, not 2, 3, 4, and 10. These are all prime numbers, 2, 3, 5, and 7, these are prime numbers. That's your cue that they are looking for prime factors. Let's begin, shall we? Very quickly. It's not that difficult. It's a very simple problem. Now that we understand what's going on, it's a very simple problem. Let's figure out 210 first. 210 first. 210, problem number 16. Problem number 16. 210 is simply made up of 21 times 10, and 10 is made up of 5 and 2, and 21, if you divide by 3, oh, that's it, 3 and 7, what the hell? This was very simple. So what did we just establish? We just established that 210 is equal to 2 times 3 times 5 times 7. So what happened here is that I removed 4 marbles at random from the container. I removed 4 marbles at random. But it turned out that I must, and I recorded their values and I multiplied the product of each of these. Let's say for example, I erased everything so I don't have it. Let's say for example, the first one I removed was the green one, and green is worth 7 points, I made a note of it. The second one I removed was the white one, I made a note of it, it was white, that's worth 3 points. The third one I removed was a blue one, that's a 5 points, and finally the last one I removed, I'm going to remove 4 marbles, the last one was red, I made a note of it, the red is worth 2 points. And then I multiplied those numbers that I removed, these point values. I multiplied the points values, 7 times 3 times 5 times 2, and the product was 210. Well, now we know that 210 is simply made up of 2 times 3 times 5 times 7, which means we must have removed one of each color was removed. That's it. One of each was removed with question number 16. Let's do question number 17. 17 is going to be tricky. 63,000. We need the room, so I'm going to erase quite a lot of it. That's it. That's question number 16. Let's do 17. 17, even though we just finished doing it, but I don't remember what it was, so I'm going to redo it very quickly. This is 1,000. And the prime factors are simply 1,000 is simply 5 times 2 raised to 3, which already tells us that we're going to have 3 of the 4 balls that are worth 5 points. We're going to have 3 of the blue one and 3 of the red ones. This tells us that we're going to have 3 red and 3, 2 points as well, 2 points was red. 3 red and 5 points were blue and 3 blues. If you remove 3 red marbles and 3 blue marbles, then what you end up is 2 times 2 times 2 and then 3 times 3 times 3
2 times 2 times 2 times 3 times 3 times 3,
or not 3 rather, blast it, I meant to say 5, you get the idea. And that comes out to be 1000, because you're going to have 5 times 5 times 5, and 2 times 2 times 2. That's 1000, let's work on 63. 63 divided by 3, we get 2 and a 1, and we get 3 and, oh, so now we have to figure out what it is. So in order to get a product of 1000, we have to have 3 red one and 3 blue one. Let me rewrite it. 3 red ones and 3 blue ones. So red ones were worth 2 points, and blue was worth 5 points. And here we have 3 squared times 7. Again, we need 2 balls worth 3 points. Two balls worth 3 points. Tell you what, instead of doing it like this, it's just getting confusing. I'm going to rewrite it in one shot. It'll be easier to see it, because it's very easy to make a mistake. This is 2 cubed, this is 3 squared, this is 5, and this is 7. There we go. Now I'm going to write down, we need balls worth 2 points, and we need 3 of them. So we have 3 red. We need balls worth 3 points, and those were white balls, and we need 2 of those. We have 2 white, and then 1 for 5 points, which was blue, and 1 for green. 1 blue and 1 green. See, one blue and 1 green. Because 63, this should say 63,000. 63,000 is equal to 2 cubed times 3 squared times 5 raised to 1 times 7 raised to 1. In other words, we remove 3 red ones, 2 white ones, 1 blue one, and 1 green one. Let's do number 18, shall we? Number 18 was 144,000. You can do it yourself now, it's very simple. Now that we understand it, it's very simple. If the product of all the points value happens to be 144,000, it seems like a huge number, but it's not. It's not, because we're going to break it up. 1,000 and 144, just like here. And 1,000 is simply 5 times 2. And now let's work on 144. Divide by 2, we get a 7 and a 2. Divide by 2, we get 3. And 1 goes, becomes 12, we get a 6, we divide by 2, we get 1 and an 8, we divide by 2, we get a 9, we get 3 and a 3. Now let's make a note of it. So 144,000 is equal to, that's a K, 144,000 is equal to 2 raised to 4 and a 2 raised to 3. Oh, this is unreal. We can't possibly have that many. I must have made a mistake in my work. Oh, of course I made a mistake in my work, because in my work, in my notes, I have 147,000. I don't recall whether I put down 147,000 at the beginning of the video or 144,000. Since we did the work for 144,000, I'm going to leave it like this, because it makes it more interesting. It makes it more interesting. Look, we have, I'm going to do it here. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, and 3. 2 raised to 7. It makes it far more interesting. 2 raised to 7 times 3 squared times 5 raised to 1. And now we're going to make a note. This is where you have to pay attention, because you don't want to muck it up at this, at the very end. We don't want to muck it up. Muck it up with an M, not an F. Okay, don't get excited. M-U-C-K. Give me 1 second. We're almost there. This is where I get paranoid. I want to make sure that my colors are right. So 2 points. 2 points were worth. 2 points were red ones, and we have 7 of those. We have 7 of those. So we have 7 red ones. 3 points were worth white ones, and we have 2 of those. We have 2 white. And 5 points was worth blue, and we have 1 of those, 1 blue, and no green. We did not draw green marbles at all, But we did happen to draw a whole bunch of red ones, as many as 7 of them. Only 2 whites, 1 blue, and no green.
Why not?